Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Moon Song James from BT143, Mr. Enterprise IT. And now I'll present to you what is World War II, the wars that shapes the world future. And now I'll touch on objective of presentation. As you can see, the first one is Europe in the 1930s, what was World War II, what is fascism, followed on by what did Hitler want, and who was on each side, and how did World War II end Europe, and finally, quick facts. And now I'll touch on Europe in the 1930s. Adolf Hitler, the Chancellor of the Germany, he rise because of World War I, and he's criticized rather than submitted for a plan for progress, and he's forced his way into the chancellorships. And Austria is the one that Hitler threatens to invade and merge with Germany. Czechoslovakia, peace is declared and no aggression pact with Stalin was made. Now, what is World War II? World War II is the largest war in human history. It involved countries, colonies, and territories around the entire world. By the end, over 70 million were dead. And it lasts from 1939 until 1945, we spread across over the year of six. And now I'll touch on how did it start. Germany invaded Poland. An ally declared war on Germany because of that. And Germany then invaded France, Belgium, and many more. Then Hitler invaded Russia using Operation Barbarossa, and Germany used Blitzkrieg to overthrow other armies. In which Blitzkrieg means lightning war in Germany, which is surrounded with tanks and troops in trucks. And what is fascism? Political belief that say that individual is less important than the nations. Glorified violence, belief in leaders, prove strength of a people, uses nationalism and racism, dictatorship is practiced, and Italy and Germany became fascists. And here are some of the pictures of the life of under the Nazi Germany. And what did Hitler ultimately want? Militarism. Soon after becoming chancellorship, he began rearming Germany, breaking the Treaty of Versailles. Rhineland, which was declared after World War I as a rearmed zone. He moved troops into the Rhineland territory, again breaking the Treaty of Versailles. And the Lebensraum, living space, which means living space in Germany, in which Austria was being annexed peacefully in 1938. Sudetenland, which is a territory in Czechoslovakia, given to Germany by Great Britain and France as appeasement policy. Hitler then invaded the rest of Czechoslovakia and finally onto Poland. And who was on his side? Mainly, there is an Axis power and Allied power. Axis power consists of Germany, Italy, and Japan, in which three of their leaders are Adolf Hitler for Germany, Benito Mussolini for Italy, and Joseph Stalin is the leader of the USSR, which is Soviet Union. And the Allied power consists of Britain, USA, and the Soviet Union, and many other countries. However, France surrendered to Germany in 1939. And so how did World War II end in Europe? The Operation Overlord, which in short means D-Day, and the Allied invasion of France. Within a month, 1 million Allied troops were stationed in Europe, and Germany is surrounded with the USSR in the east, and hence they are both fighting, and Germany is fighting in both fronts. And Germany surrendered in 1945 when the USSR pushes into Berlin. And here are some of the quick facts of World War II. The war cost of World War II for the US is during the 1940s, 9 billion, in which during the 1945, the US then has increased to 98 billion. And World War II cost $330 billion, 10 times the cost of World War I, and equivalent to all previous federal spending since 1776. And now I've come to my end of presentations and hope that you have enjoyed. Thank you.